Static type checking is the most important thing to avoid errors ahead of time. Just by adding colon followed by the types to the variables, function parameters, and return types, we can annotate the type to the data. TypeScript supports all the primitive data types of JavaScript. String, number, Boolean are the most widely used primitive types. There are two ways TypeScript assign a type, implicit and explicit. When we declare a variable with a value, TypeScript will infer the type from the value and assign the type to it, which you can see while hovering over it. On the other hand, if we annotate the type, it's the explicit way. Arrays can be annotated in two ways: type followed by square bracket and array followed by type inside the angle bracket. Either of these ways, we can annotate an array. Here, the type refers to the type of the array, whether it's string, number, Boolean. Tuple is an array with predefined length and types for each index or position. In this case, we have string, number, and Boolean. So the array has to be three entries with string, number, and Boolean as order. To define an object type, we can simply list its properties with types. In order to reuse this type, we can put this type into type aliases or interface like this. Interface is the most preferred one for object types. Optional data can be represented using question mark. In this example, I have used in tuples and property in interface. We can extend from other interfaces just like this instead of duplicating the properties. Union is a type formed from multiple types, represent any one from those types, whereas intersection combines multiple types into one. Literal type refers to the literal value. In this case, Zoref is the literal type. We can combine literal type with union to produce multiple possibilities. If you take this case, the possibilities are 1, 2, and 3. You can also check by hovering over the let and const variables. You can find the difference between string and the literal type. Type assertion is similar to typecasting, but it doesn't reconstruct the code. When we want to change a variable from one type to another type, such as any to string, we can use this. This can be done in two ways, using as keyword or using angle bracket. To avoid mutation, we can use read-only access modifiers. This can be used in classes, interface, arrays, and tuples. Generics allows us to create reusable components, which can work with a variety of data types rather than a single data type.